Hello, I'm here to introduce the Easy Model Compositing add-on for Blender 3D. This add-on is specifically aimed towards VFX artists and other Blender users who want to quickly and easily get their separate object, shadow, and ambient occlusion passes out of Blender all at once. This allows you to use your compositing software of choice, such as Photoshop, After Effects, or HitFilm, to better integrate your models into a real environment, showing off how good they look. For single frames, or even full animations, this add-on allows you to automatically set up your scene and export these passes into convenient folders when you hit render. Best of all, this add-on allows you to get a shadow pass from any environment map you have set up, something a standard shadow pass doesn't include. So let's dive right in. In order to install the add-on, you go to File, User Preferences, Add-ons, and click Install from File. Then, we'll navigate to the product directory, and inside you'll see an Easy Model Compositing V1.0 zip. We don't need to unpack this, we just click it, hit Install from File, and make sure to check off and activate the add-on. Then we're going to save our user preferences. Now that the node is installed and activated, you should see the menu for it at the bottom of your render settings panel. If we scroll down, we'll see this menu with buttons for setting our subjects, shadow catchers, and render settings. Optionally, we have extras for importing my Titan Space Hauler Mesh and original PBR Material node, both included free with this product. So let's set up a test scene. I'm going to press Import Titan Model, and you'll see that the Titan model is added to our scene with its materials already set up. Next, I'm going to add a ground plane, which will act to catch our shadows. Finally, I'm going to add a camera, and I'm going to add our background image, which in this case is a royalty-free picture of a helipad I grabbed from Pixabay, which will be included in the product directory. Now I'm going to go ahead and move our camera roughly into position. I'm also going to go ahead and add an environment map to get some natural light and reflections. I've included this map by Greg Zoll in the product directory as well, so you can follow along. Finally, I'm going to return to my render settings panel and go back to our add-on. I'm going to select our subject, in this case the Titan model, and in our add-on, press Setup Subject. Next, I'm going to select our ground plane and hit Setup Shadow Catchers. Finally, I'm going to click Use Preview Background, Use Image Dimensions, and once again find our background image. Now I can hit Setup Render, and that's it. The add-on takes care of the rest. If we scroll up, we can see that the add-on has automatically set up our output resolution to match that preview image we just added. And if we go down, we'll see that it's turned our film transparency on to get our alpha channel. We're almost ready to render, but before we do, we need to save our project file because our render passes will automatically be saved in the same directory as our .blend. Now, all we have to do is hit render and Blender will take care of the rest. I'm going to go ahead and do that, and I'll join you once we're done. And here we go! We can see a preview of our output on the background image. Now, the camera perspective was a little bit off, that's okay, we were just roughing it for this tutorial. We also didn't spend any time trying to match our environment lighting to our background, which makes post-production a bit of a headache, but I digress. The preview image that Blender shows us here is roughly what our output might look like, but the real magic is in our project folder. Going to our project folder, we can see a newly created render output folder, and inside, you'll see folders for our AO, object, and shadow passes. This means that if you're rendering an animation, such as a 3D tracked VFX shot, you can render your animation, and these folders will automatically be created and filled. Then you can just drag these image sequences straight into After Effects and work with them as clips. No problem. And that's it, we're done. That's really all there is to it. No render layers and exclusions, no having to create folders, no real setup involved, no hassle. the add-on takes care of all the hard work and conveniently outputs the files organized for you to more easily composite your artwork in your software of choice. This add-on frees you to focus on what you do best, making art. I hope this has been useful, and have a great day.